Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. Today, I am going to talk about one of the features of C programming, that is how to pass an array, specifically 2D array, to the function. For this, you must know the basic knowledge about an array, basic knowledge about 2D array, as well as the basic knowledge about functions. I would like to help you to know all these things. For you, I am going to provide a shortcut path in right up corner where you can go through my previous video sessions for these topics. You can pause this video and you can go through that video if you are not known about arrays, 2D arrays and the functions. Now, currently, I am assuming that you are knowing the concept of arrays as well as the functions. So now, I would like to forward to the IDE for practical demonstration of this program, how to pass 2D array to the function. So now, let's start with the program. Here a simple program I have written where one matrix of size 3 by 3 is declared over here. This matrix declaration is nothing but the 2D array declaration. This is of type integer. Total 9 number of values it will hold. 3 values in every column. And that many 3 rows will be there. So, 3 values in every column and 3 number of rows will be there. So, that's why 3 into 3 are equal to 9 will be the size of this variable matrix. This is 2D array. That's why it will require nested for loop for any operation which we want to perform on the matrix. So, now let's consider here. First of all, I am going to read the values of matrix from user. So that's why I need to use the outer for loop for 3 number of rows, and for every row the column values are nothing but 3, that is 3 number of columns will be there. So for every row 3 values in every column will be there. So that's why inner for loop will work for number of columns. So here I would like to explain, this for loop is for the number of rows who are available in your matrix, and this for loop will be for columns in your matrix. Now here the variable name is matrix, so that's why I need to provide here the address of matrix for ith and jth position. For ith and jth position, the value will get accepted over here. After accepting a value, here I am trying to display the matrix in a matrix form. For this again outer for loop is for row position, inner for loop is for column position, and with the help of printf statement, I am trying to display all the values who are available in my matrix variable. So now let's try for the execution of this program. I am going to execute this and my program is now waiting for the input. So now here I am taking the input to my program are nothing but the 9 values in my matrix, and here we are getting the output like entered matrix is, and we are displaying all the contents in a rows and in columns form. So now this is nothing but the basic about how to accept an array, 2D array, and how to display it. But the same thing if I want to do with the help of functions, what I need to do. So very first thing, now let's try for displaying the content of matrix with the help of function by passing a parameter as a matrix to the function. So here I am giving the name to my function is display. As I want to pass a matrix as a parameter, I need to provide its data type. integer and I need to pass the matrix. That's why this will indicate that the whatever parameter we are going to pass to function will be of type 2D array. Here we need to keep in mind the column size, it is mandatory and we need to provide it. This is nothing but your function prototype declaration. So here I would like to explain or I would like to give the comment like this is nothing but the function declaration. Now let's see what will be the definition for this function. So I'd like to define the function like the function name is display. Here I need to collect the whatever I am going to pass to the function in integer type variable of two type 2D array, and here I need to provide the size of the matrix, that is how many columns are there, how many rows are there. After that I would like to write down the body or the content or a line of code of my function. So what I need to do, I need to perform the same task but in the function. So that's why for simplicity I am going to cut this line of code from my main program and I am going to paste it in the definition of my function matrix. Now here I need to make simple changes like the variable name of matrix is m, so that's why I need to give variable name m over here. The next important thing is I need to declare the index variables I and j in my function. That's it. Now after that, is it needed to return anything back from the function display? No. That's why I'll mention the return type of my function is void. The same change I need to do in the declaration of my function. So that's why I'm going to provide over here the return type as display. So what is this? This is nothing but my function definition. Correct? Now here, function definition we have done with the function declaration. Now let's see what will be the function call. So to make a function call, I need to write down the same name to the function ended with a semicolon. But my function is parameterized function. Here I am going to pass one parameter to the function. That will be a 2D array. So what I need to pass as a parameter? So keep in mind, this is very important thing as far as today's session is concerned. What we need to pass to the function, or how to call a function by passing 2D array as a parameter. So the answer is, we need to pass the base address of the 2D array as a parameter to the function. This is nothing but a variable which is 2D array, which is already declared in my function, whose size is 3 by 3. For this, I am going to pass its base address. That base address is going to be collected in a variable m of the same size and is nothing but the 2D array again of the same data type integer. In this way, we can make a call to the function. So now let's see whether we are getting the correct output or not. Now one more important thing, as the return type of function is void, so that's why we are not going to return back anything from a function. That's why it's not needed to collect the return value. So that's why there will not be any return type of this function. So now let's check whether we are getting the correct output or not. So now let's execute a function again, sorry, program again, and now let's check the output, what will be the output for my code. Now this program is waiting for input. Now let's try to give next input to the program. So here I am going to give these 9 values to my program, and now let's check whether I am getting the correct output or not. Yes, I am getting the correct output. So here entered matrix is. So what we have done, we have first of all declare a function over here, we have written the function definition, and here we have made a function call to the same function. So now my next task is to accept the matrix from function again. So I'll write down one more function over here. So now I'm going to write down the name of my function is nothing but accept. Here I need to provide the parameter to my function is nothing but again 2D array. So that's why I need to provide the parameter to this function as of size 3 by 3. Here it's not necessary to provide the row size, but the column size is mandatory. So now what I need to write down in the definition of my function. So here I would like to write down the name of my function is nothing but accept. What I need to pass as a parameter, so its data type is integer. Here I am providing the name of my matrix is M of the size 3 by 3. So that's why here I am providing the size 3 by 3. After that, I need to write down the body of my function where I need to accept the values from user. So that's why I am going to cut all these things from main function and I am going to paste it within the accept function. Now here we need to keep in mind to make a change in the variable name, as I have declared the variable of name M. So that's why I need to provide the M as a variable name over here. Now here I am going to use the index variables I and J. That's why I need to declare it in my function I and J. Now the next thing, I need to make a function call. So what I need to write down to make a function call. So now here I need to give the function name over here provided by the base address of 2D array, that is nothing but the matrix, and ended with a semicolon. Same thing whatever we have done in the display function. Now the next important thing, as we are not going to return back anything from a function, so that's why its return type will be void. The same change I need to do while declaration of my function, its return type will be void. Now let's check whether we are getting the output or not. So now let's execute again a program, and here it is waiting for the input. So I am taking the input from user, next 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, and 90. Now let's check whether we are getting the same output or not. So yes, it is giving the same output for my program. So what we have done? We have passed whatever the memory allotted for my matrix. For this matrix, I am going to pass its base address to the function accept. That base address is going to be collected in variable M, and for that many values, it will accept the values from a user. The same matrix we are going to pass to the display function. Here again, this M is going to become formal argument, and with that variable we are trying to display it. Now let's see if I'll remove this size or the row size from my function, whether my program will work or not. So now let's re-execute a code. Here I'm going to give the input, and yes, I'm getting the same output for my program. So in this way we can perform our practical. So now thank you dear friends for listening my video. If you like the content and the video, please like the video and subscribe my channel. Thank you.